going to be recreating or implementing ChatGPT in the terminal. This is what we're going to be building today. We're going to be using Python, OpenAI, Typer, and a lot of other things, so follow along and let's do it. All right, first let's focus on setting everything up. The first thing we're going to install is PyEnv. It manages all of your Python installations. So I'm just going to do that by running this command. I'm doing this all on a Mac, but if you're in a different OS like Windows or Linux, I'll include the installation instructions in the description of this video. Okay, now we also need to install PyEnv virtualenv. This gives us the ability to create virtual environments outside of our Python installations, and it's very common practice in software development. This way we can isolate the Python environments and also manage dependencies for different projects. Again, I am doing this on a Mac, so I'm going to run this command. And again, if you're on a different OS like Windows or Linux, I'll make sure to include the instructions below. And finally, I'm going to run this command to install some dependencies for this project, and I'll explain what each of them does later when we get into the code. All right, now that everything is installed, let's initialize our project. I'm going to go ahead and create an empty directory and call it a ChatGPT clone because that's what we're building. And now we're going to create a virtual environment by running this command. And in essence, what this command is doing is saying that we can use Python 3.11 with a virtual environment called ChatGPT clone. And now let's activate it by running this command. And yeah, as you can tell, Python is not as easy to configure as coding languages like JavaScript, but we still love it. All right, time to get into the code. So first I'm going to create a main.py file in my ChatGPT clone project. And in this Python file, let's import all the dependencies we downloaded earlier, like Typer, OpenAI, DotEnv, and OS packages. I said earlier that I would explain all these packages, so let me do that. OS gets our API key securely. Typer is what's going to handle the command line, like print things on the command line or pass in parameters to the command. OpenAI just handles everything related to ChatGPT functionality. And load.env is going to read your .env file and make certain variables like your OpenAI API key accessible in your code. Now, if you're sitting here thinking, what the heck is a .env file? What the heck is this open API key? Don't worry, let's get it set up right now. In your ChatGPT clone directory, run touch.env to create your .env file, and then vi.env to start editing that file that you just created. Then you want to go into your Open API account, go to API keys, and then click on generate a new secret key. Then copy that key that you get to your clipboard. Now in your .env file that you're currently editing, type in OpenAI underscore key, and then paste in that code that you just copied. And then you want to press escape colon WQ to save and quit out of that file. One other thing you want to do is you want to make sure that you have the credit balance to make API requests to OpenAI, since each request does cost money. So go back to your account, go to billing, and then fill in your credit balance for whatever dollar amount you want to spend. Now back to our code in main.py, we're going to first set up our API key and also create an application object called app. All right, so now we're all set up, let's make some magic happen. The way that I like to code, I like to start with the easiest option and then work up and optimize from there. So let's do that. I'm first going to create a function called interactive chat, and I will use the echo command from Typer to welcome our users. Typer recognizes commands by using decorators that go on top of a function. So you can kind of think of it like a name tag that tells your boss that your name is Bob and that you work at the IT department. Then we'll just add the classic loop in Python at the bottom, and here's what we have after all of that is done. Now when we run Python main.py, we get it to run with no errors. Of course, nothing really happens, so let's just keep coding. Here I'm going to add an infinite loop that prompts the user for a chat input and calls the OpenAI chat completion model. Note, if you get an error like this, you may just have to wait for 5 to 10 minutes for the billing information that you just entered to be recognized by OpenAI. So don't worry, just wait a couple minutes and then try again. Okay, so once I call the OpenAI chat completion model, if I were to print the response I get back from OpenAI, I would get a JSON object that looks like this. I'll save you the trouble of having to figure it out yourself, but this is the specific code that you have to put in to drill down into the JSON object to get the response to your prompt. So this is what we have so far. Let's run the command again, python main.py. So this is really awesome. This works and it's calling OpenAI, but we can see some problems already, like the fact that it has short-term memory. For example, if I ask it this question of how many letters the previous question had, my current code cannot answer that question. So let's fix this. Let's give ChatGPT a memory. So you see here where it says messages, this array of objects is what is causing ChatGPT to understand context. So this is actually a really simple fix. First, we're going to define an empty list called messages. Underneath our prompt, let's add what's already in messages in the API call and then append it to our messages list. Now let's do the same thing after we receive an API call back, and now we're going to replace messages in the API call with our message list that we just defined. And then we're going to test it and it works. So it's pretty awesome. So now ChatGPT works kind of as we expect it, but there are lots of ways that we're going to make it better. Right now, all of the OpenAI functionality is hard-coded into the API call. So you'd have to actually go into the code if you wanted to tweak things like max tokens or the model that we're using or even like the temperature of that response. So what we're going to implement next is a way to specify all of those parameters when you're actually just running the command. We're going to use typer.option function where it allows us to set a parameter that users can pass in when they run the command, as well as a default value and a help message. So now if I type in my command with the dash dash help flag, I get a response like this. This is starting to feel a lot more professional now. Let's also make sure we, in our code, change the API call to include the variables that we just defined. Okay, now let's test this. I'm pretty happy with the temperature of the response I'm getting and the model that we're using. So let's go ahead and change the max tokens from the command that we're typing in. And as you can see, this abrupt end in my program means that max tokens worked because ChatGPT is limiting the amount of tokens it's sending back. Okay, and finally, I wanted to wrap up this coding session by optimizing my program a little bit. I don't want to start up my program and then have to ask my question. I want to ask my question right off the bat. So I'm going to add a dash T argument here that can let us put in a string of our first question right off the bat. I'm also going to make this optional so the user doesn't have to input their question when they're running the command. And just like that, we've made our own ChatGPT clone in just a couple of minutes. If you want to see the source code, you can check out everything in the description of this video. And I just want to say that this is, of course, a very basic implementation of how to bring AI to your command line. If you'd like to try out a more polished version that we have built, I would suggest you check out Warp AI. Warp AI is a level above what we've built today. It can help you debug your existing command line errors. You can also easily execute commands outputted by AI with a click of a button instead of having to copy paste things. It's also optimized to answer terminal related or coding questions. So it probably won't be able to answer things like how do I make my favorite sandwich, but it'll definitely level you up as a developer. And finally, Warp AI is actually free to use, so you don't have to bill your own API credits. If you want to learn more, just check out the links in our description, and I hope to see you in the next video.